creating first Node application and running our first local server in Node. From the previous video, we know that how Node uses virtual machine such as V8 engine to execute JavaScript. Well, this is something that happens in the backend server. Now this backend server needs to be consumed by some front-end client. And this client can be a mobile device such as Android or iOS or even a website. The communication between front-end and back-end takes place using HTTP request and response. So in this video, you will learn how to set up a local web server using Node and run your first code in Node. Let's begin. So open your terminal if you are on Mac or Linux, or open your command prompt if you are on Windows. Also, before you start, you have to download your exercise files of this course, the link to which is available in the description below the video. Once you download the files, you will get this folder, 4-first-app. Within that, you will find these two files. So make sure you open these two files. So here I am using Sublime Text Editor. You can use any editor of your own choice. And also, once you download the exercise files, you have to navigate to this folder in your terminal or command prompt. So simply type cd, give it a space, and drag and drop this folder. Hit enter. So now we are inside this folder. Let us type ls to find out the file content. So these are the two files that are present here. So both of them are in the same folder. Alright, so here is the Node Hello World example on the right, which is an example of a very simple web server. Well, do not worry about this code here. We will break it down into smaller pieces and understand it well. Now to execute this file, all you have to do is type node space the file name, hit tab, and then hit enter. Well, if the script you are executing contains a running task like a web server listening for a connection, then Node will continue to run. Like here, our server is up and running. To stop this program or to end this task, you need to press Ctrl plus C. When you press it, your Node process will eventually terminate. But on the other hand, for example, in this file of printhello.js, we have a very small script that just do not contain a running task. For example, here we are just printing a message. So if you run this file, then Node will immediately execute this file and automatically terminate by just printing out the message like this. Now, when the Node is idle, that is, it is waiting for your next command, then it won't consume your resources in the background. But if you run this script again, let us clear our terminal by pressing Ctrl plus L and run the script again, then the Node process will become active and start to consume resources. This means when your server is up and running, it listens to all the HTTP connections. However, this Node process will only use V8, that is our virtual machine in the backend, to execute JavaScript only when there is an established HTTP connection. Otherwise, the V8 will remain idle. So now that you know how to execute your JavaScript code, let us explore our first code. So the very first line is the require function. This is a constant variable and this is a require function. Well, this require function is used to manage your script dependencies. You can use this require function to include any library such as HTTP in our case in your script. Well, in Node, we generally refer to such thing as a module, but you can call it as library as well. So you can call this HTTP as a HTTP module or HTTP library. And this module can be the built-in module or it can be some external third-party module. But here, this HTTP module is a built-in Node module. And this HTTP module has a feature of creating a web server. Well, there are many other libraries apart from HTTP to create a web server. But this module is a built-in module present in Node, so you don't need to install anything extra to use it, but you just need to use the require function to include it in your script. Once you include the module, you can use its function, such as here we are using createServer function that belongs to HTTP module. Well, this function is responsible to create a simple web server. and it accepts one parameter, and this parameter is known as request listener. Now if you notice, this parameter looks pretty weird, but if you take a look at this parameter, then you will find that it is actually a function. A function without any name, such as this whole parameter, a single parameter is actually a function. Here you will find that it is the two parameter of this anonymous function, a function without name. And then we have a method body right here. The syntax is a bit different, but it is actually a function. Now in JavaScript, you can pass a function as a parameter to another function. Like here we are passing a function within the create server method or the function. Well, at once, if you are a beginner in JavaScript, this might look pretty weird, but trust me, you will get used to it. Because in JavaScript, you can pass a function as a parameter to some other function. And don't worry about this if it is new to you. I will talk about it in detail in my upcoming videos as well. For now, let us focus on the concept. Now this function receives the first parameter as the request object. And this request object is basically the HTTP request coming from the client. That is, whenever there is a HTTP request from the client, the server will invoke this function. Right now it is named as rec. You can name it as per your wish. For example, I can change it to request. And then save the file. Now the other argument that this listener function receives is the response object. Right now it is res. You can again rename it to response or any other desired name of your choice. But accordingly, you have to make sure change its occurrence as well. For example, here res becomes response. And then let us format the code as it was before. Perfect. Well, this response is actually the HTTP response object which server sends back to the client after doing some modification. Here I have shown a very simple modification of response object using the end function. I am inserting a body to the object that contains a string which says hello world. Perfect. Well, you will learn about this end function in detail in my upcoming videos of the series. But for now, just remember, the end function writes data and then end the connection. So overall, this create server function just creates the server. But our server is not yet activated. To activate our web server, we have a special function. We need to call listen function on our created server, which you can find here. Once you call it, the server gets activated. Now again, this function accepts several parameters, like what OS port to use for this server. Well, you can change this port number, which is currently 4242, to 9000 or even 7000. Like this, it is totally up to your choice. Let's keep it 9000 for now. Now the second argument here is actually a function. Let us take a look at this parameter from a different angle. So again we have a function as a second parameter, but this time this function has no parameter. It just has a body that prints out server is running. Again format the code back to what it was before. So this function will be invoked when the server starts to run on this port address. So within this function you can write your own code. Now it is time to run our server. After you do some changes, save the file and then here, shut down the old node server. Press Ctrl plus C, rerun your node server. Great. You can then open your browser and then ping that URL. So I will use localhost then colon 9000. Well, this 9000 is actually the port number that we have defined here. So we are getting hello world. Now this hello world is the same message that we have mentioned here in the response object. If you want, you can change it. For example, hello from different world. Save it and then open your terminal, shut down the old server, Ctrl C and rerun this server again. Go to your browser and refresh the page. You will get hello from different world. How cool is that? If you now terminate your server, Ctrl C, and then refresh the page, then you will get nothing. The site cannot be reached. because we have just shut down our server. Okay, now, as a beginner, there must be several questions and curiosity to know more about this script. What else is happening, how this end function works, and what this port actually is. So in the next video, we will continue our discussion and dive deeper and inspect the code. See you there.